We are co-workers with him, October 2nd. Service for God and with God. We then, as workers together with him, beseech you also that ye receive not the grace of God in vain. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 1. In the life of Christ, everything was made subordinate to his work, the great work of redemption which he came to accomplish. And the same devotion, the same self-denial and sacrifice, the same subjection to the claims of the Word of God, is to be manifest in his disciples. Everyone who accepts Christ as his personal Savior will long for the privilege of serving God. Contemplating what heaven has done for him, his heart is moved with boundless love and adoring gratitude. He is eager to signalize his gratitude by devoting his abilities to God's service. He longs to show his love for Christ and for his purchased possession. He covets toil, hardship, sacrifice. The true worker for God will do his best, because in so doing he can glorify his master. He will do right in order to regard the requirements of God. He will endeavor to improve all his faculties. He will perform every duty as unto God. His one desire will be that Christ may receive homage and perfect service. There is a picture representing a bullock standing between a plow and an altar, with the inscription, "Ready for either, ready to toil in the furrow or to be offered on the altar of sacrifice." This is the position of the true child of God, willing to go where duty calls, to deny self, to sacrifice for the Redeemer's cause. The Ministry of Healing, 502. The talents, however few, are to be put to use. The question that most concerns us is not, how much have I received? But, what am I doing with that which I have? Christ's Object Lessons, 329.